News review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use a language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. I'm Catherine and joining me today is Dan. Hello, Dan.
Hello, everybody. Sorry, I was a bit eager there. Hi.
And what's today's story, Dan?
Our story is about a warning for anyone with an iPhone or an Apple device.
A warning, very interesting. Okay, and let's hear more from this BBC World Service news report.
Apple has warned of a glitch that makes it possible to eavesdrop on users of its iPhone and Mac devices. The problem is linked to the FaceTime feature, which is used for video calls. The company said a fix would be available in days.
So, if you have an Apple device, you may be familiar with FaceTime. That's allowing you to make a video call across distance.
Sure.
And Apple's latest software allows you to do something called group FaceTime.
Yep.
But there's a problem. If you group FaceTime dial someone, you're able to see through the camera on their device or listen to the audio through their microphone, even if they haven't picked up the phone.
Wow. So if I call you, even if you don't pick up,
you can hear what I'm saying.
I can still see and hear you.
For a very brief period. I mean, eventually the call will end naturally, but it is a bit of a problem in terms of privacy. So it relates only to the group chat function, and it only affects operating systems 12.1 or later. And Apple have promised that they will be releasing a fix to correct the problem within days.
Thanks, Dan. And you've been looking around at the world's media and the language they're using to talk about this story. And you picked out three words and expressions. What are they?
We've got bug, eavesdrop, and patch.
Bug, eavesdrop, and patch. And let's go straight to your first headline.
So my first headline comes from The Independent and says, Apple FaceTime bug allows caller to snoop on iPhone audio and video without recipient's knowledge.
Bug, fault in a computer program. Now, a bug is a little insect, isn't it? A beetle or a worm or
an ant or some sort of
butterfly.
Fly.
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah.
So what's going on?
Well, it's a very common expression to say bug, meaning small insect, especially in American English. However, this is related, certainly in its history, and we'll come back to that in a minute, but it's not the same thing. So a bug, in this case, it relates only to computing, and it's a noun, and it means a general fault in the computer program. And we're talking software here, not mechanical problems. So if your computer screen, your monitor, if it breaks, that's not a bug. That's a mechanical problem.
Okay.
It's a coding problem.
So when it's like you're looking at your screen and weird things are happening.
Weird stuff happens.
Like, that's a bug.
My phone is so old, it has a particular bug in it that when I take a photo with the camera, it sometimes makes a phone call. I don't know why, but I like to think it gives the phone character. So
just wants to send a photo to tell everyone
could
you're
be.
Making you're
taking He's taking
photo.
Another photo,
taking
quick.
That's so, an example of a bug.
That's an example of a bug. Now, the expression or the meaning of this, this word, because the word's been around for a long time, actually comes back from 1945 and from Harvard University, where they had something called the Mark II calculator, which was a computer that was like the size of a room. It was so big back then. And a moth, which is a kind of a
night butterfly,
a nighttime
isn't it?
Butterfly, yeah, yeah. Exactly. So a moth flew into the computer and settled on the components and died, unfortunately, but it caused a big problem with the calculations. And when they investigated, they literally found a bug in the system. And
wow.
That's where the expression comes from.
So the original bug has named every other bug in a computer system, that moth.
That's
wow.
Right. It's cool. So, we often say that a bug in the system.
The preposition there.
The preposition being in. So a bug in the program, a bug in the computer, a bug in the system.
And any synonyms for bug?
Absolutely. We have defect, we have error, we have fault, and we have glitch, which is interesting because we'll be coming back to that later in our social media challenge.
Can't wait.
Yeah. And finally, to remove a bug from a computer, you debug.
Debug.
That's right.
Fabulous little prefix, D. Very, very useful prefix. Okay, let's move on to your next headline, please, Dan.
Our next headline comes from The Guardian and says, Apple rushes to fix FaceTime bug that lets users eavesdrop on others.
eavesdrop, secretly listen to someone's conversation.
Absolutely. Now, this is a verb, and it's a regular verb, which means I eavesdrop, I eavesdropped, and I have eavesdropped. And it's one word that's made up of two smaller words. So we have eaves and drop. Now, eaves, and it's an unusual spelling, it's E-A-V-E-S. Eaves are the edges of a roof that stick out over the top of a wall. This is, of course, to let the rain run off so that the rain doesn't affect the wall itself. It goes out into space and over into the, I don't know, into the garden or something like that. So those are eaves. Drop, in this case, is not necessarily to let go of something, but more closely related to the phrasal verb drop in, which would be like visit. So if you eavesdrop, you visit the eaves of someone's property. Now, why might we want to do that?
Well, Dan, if you're as nosy and inquisitive as I am, it's because you want to hear what's going on in there.
There you go.
But you don't want anybody to know that you're doing it.
Exactly that. So we've got this idea of listening, but secretly.
Secretly.
That's it. So we secretly listen to someone's conversation. Yes.
Okay. I love doing that. So you can... but. Often, you're not actually in a house in this case.
No.
So this is quite an idiomatic use, isn't
Absolutely,
it? It's
yes.
like spying or snooping or virtually.
Yeah, I mean, it's very much the original idea may have come from that, but certainly these days we use it in all contexts. So, for example, when I go home on the train, I might be reading a book, but or I look like I'm reading a book, but then I hear someone say something very interesting and I'm like, ooh.
Ooh.
What's going on in that conversation? Maybe I'll just eavesdrop a little over here. Who did what with what? What's going on? You know, that kind
Love
of thing.
Doing that.
Yeah.
Yes. Very exciting. Eavesdropping.
That's it. And we eavesdrop on something.
Okay.
So you eavesdrop on a phone call, you eavesdrop on a conversation, or you eavesdrop on a meeting or anything else.
And what do we call a person who eavesdrops?
A person who eavesdrops is known as an eavesdropper.
An eavesdropper.
That's it.
Love to be an eavesdropper. Thank you very much, Dan. And now let's have your final headline.
Our final headline comes from Reuters and says, Apple to patch privacy bug in video calling feature.
Patch. Correct a program by inserting a fix. Now, Dan, let's talk about jeans.
I love jeans. Go for it.
I love jeans as well. And I actually quite like ripped jeans.
Okay.
And if I get a hole in my jeans, I take a small piece of denim and I sew it over the hole. And that piece of fabric is called a patch.
Like a little square one. Yeah.
Little, usually square.
I know.
Sew it on to fix a hole.
Mm-hmm.
And these days, actually, you can spend a lot of money on designer patches on your jeans. You don't just do them to fix holes. So it's a fashion thing, isn't it? Or it's a repair, you know, fake.
That's it. It's this idea of repair. I mean, certainly in terms of fashion, that. But the patching idea, the repairing idea, that's exactly key to understanding this meaning.
Okay.
So... patch is a verb with an object, so you patch a program or you patch genes, but obviously the meanings are slightly different. We're talking computing here. So you patch a program, but patch can also be a noun. So I'm uploading a patch to the computer, for example. And basically, as you've said, you make a small repair which saves the thing that you're patching. So in your case, you're patching your genes so you can wear them again.
Yeah.
And if you patch a program, then you insert a small program into that larger program to fix it, to correct an error that that program is making. Often when you get software that's been running for a long time, they will update it in small stages because it's no point downloading the whole software again. So they give you updates as patches.
So a series of small patches,
exactly.
Small bits of program that fix the whole program and keep it usable.
Yep, version 2, version 3, version 4.
Fabulous. And can we have the vocabulary recap, Dan, please?
You most certainly can. So, first of all, we had bug, fault in a computer program. Then we had eavesdrop, secretly listen to someone's conversation. And finally, patch, correct a program by inserting a fix.
Fantastic. And if you'd like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com. You can also join us on all the usual social media platforms, and we're hoping to see you here next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Bye.
News review from BBC Learning English.